best is the Grand Prix, the Indianapolis 500, the Daytona 500 of the offshore powerboat racing?
If someone wants to be the top of his sport, they have to come to Key West.
The big thing about Key West is this is a body of water that everybody thinks they got figured out, but nobody's ever got it figured out.
Well, Key West is a unique thing because of the three-race format, and the weather's never usually the same.
The boats now will be getting bigger, they'll be getting faster, and they'll be getting louder as the day progresses. That's why we are really getting amped up. And I tell you what, when these guys get out there today on this very, very fast track, once again, they're going to be letting it all hang out.
Attention all race boats, respond to the bending area.
Going to win it all, baby. Going to win it all.
Winning here is what it's about. This is not a game. This is the real deal.
Once that hatch closes and that green flag goes, there's nothing like it in the world.
We have a green flag. Let's go racing. We are going racing superboat style.
It's just been really competitive the whole time, and we're not taking anything for granted. It's going to be really exciting and a real nail biter.
I think every boat here could win this race.
It's so difficult to say who's going to be the guy that I got to beat. I got to beat them all.
There's always been a bullseye on my back, but, you know, bring it on. I don't care.
I'm going to go over him and then hit him.
Everyone's going to fight to get position. Everyone's going to fight to get the turn. Everybody's going to fight to be where they need to be.
And look how close they are. This is unbelievable.
We were bumping, coming in all the way around. We were bumping at the turns. It was definitely a drag race out there. It was unbelievable.
We got it now. Intimidation at its finest.
It's a tight race course, you know. It's a 4.3-mile lap. So when you have these tight race courses and everybody's kind of evenly matched and coming in and turn together, things happen, unfortunately.
Getting ready to line up next thing I know, I just saw the whole bottom of their boat on top of me, and pretty much our world championship was over right then and there.
Oh, my God, they missed it. Oh, my goodness.
You're not running 100% the whole time. You're going to be left behind.
Trying to get out of his white rock. I am.
Remembering that these boats shoot out a 75-foot rooster tail. It's not like an automobile race where one can be right behind another.
Where did that come from?
Hey guys, we're done. This thing's hurt bad.
It's just you gotta make sure you pick a lane, hold your lane, and everybody's gonna be running for that same turn.
Look at this!
Yeah, it's an all-out competitive race out there.
Because at the speeds we reach, everything's gotta be right. A tiniest little nut, a wire here, the boat out of balance. Could be disastrous.
The spin out was extremely violent. It threw him out of the back of the boat.
Oh my goodness, they get upset when they were awake. Woo! Bob Christie just got ejected.
Nobody lays down day one, day two, or day three. There is no lay down. You have to go out and you have to run every day, hard every day.
Superboat World Championships, presented by Steel.
Superboat International, and these are the World Championships. Welcome to Key West, Florida. You got to come here to beat the best comers from all over the world, a unique three-race format for all of these teams, all of these classes we are covering here. And we start with the NASCAR of classes, Superboat.
Day one is important because where you set yourself up in day one really determines what day three is.
You can't win the race on Wednesday, but you certainly can't lose. It's a flat day out there, so we're expecting it to be a fast race, and we're in good shape.
We'll go out there and see how we do. We got 9 boats in our field, which is the biggest field we've ever raced against.
I think every boat here could win this race. This is the first day. It's survival. Go out, put yourself in a decent position, and keep your ride set up, and don't break anything.
Don't break anything. Good advice, but easier said than done. Tommy Sanders here with the voice of the sport, Stan Lane. And Stan, as you've always pointed out, one of the biggest obstacles of all is this constantly shifting race course.
It is ever changing, Tommy, and this is the granddaddy of offshore racing courses.
Turn number one, they call it the wall, and they call it that for a reason. Very, very discombobulated water out there. And then you make your way, as we are right now, down to turn number two. Not that treacherous, but as soon as you crown turn number two, you hit that big trench area, and that can upset the boat. And then they head down towards the outer mole area, where we are slam-packed with fans, and they reach those very, very high speeds of upwards of 130 miles per hour.
This course here at Key West generally laying out north and south. The numbers for this course, 9 laps, 4.5 miles per lap. And again, this is the Superboat class coming up right now.
Superboat, please respond to the milling area. All superboats, respond to the milling area.
We're ready. Let's go.
Okay. Get us up there.
Ready?
Yep.
That's our pace boat, that yellow one, I believe.
Smoke in the water. Broco 05, we have smoke.
That far, good luck, guys.
Well, for these boats in the Superboat class, this week of racing, this championship week almost underway. Stan, we are lined up and ready to start.
It is go time. Yellow flag goes down, green flag comes up, and we are going racing. Hammers to the wall, full throttle now. Great battle shaping up already. On the inside is Amsoil. On the outside is Cleveland Construction. Look at them go.
Well, the Amsoil team from Valencia, California, Bob Teague and company, seems like they're always in the thick of things on this championship week.
They have the shortest boat in the fleet. That might be an advantage to them in these pretty benign water conditions. Let's jump on board now. Paul Whittier on the left, Bob Teague on the right. Seesaw on the throttle.
Yeah, Bob Teague, sort of a mechanical genius, always has the boat ready to go. It's the strategies, it's the propeller selection and so forth that concerns him.
Headed down now to the start and finish line. Look at that speedometer, 120 miles per hour. Oh.
This is where full sound and fury comes across to these thousands and thousands waiting to see this leg of the race.
Oh, look at the battle for second place. Cleveland Construction getting by WHM.
You all right?
Yep.
Definitely in the hunt on this race. Number 13, the Steel Offshore Racing Team. Bob Noble, Mark Kowalski, definitely trying to stay in touch with the leaders. Don't lose ground.
Got Cleveland right here. Just drive it wide, drive it wide.
Drama all over this race course, but everything gets exaggerated in the turn stand. That's where so much of the give and take takes place.
Exactly. Let's not lose sight of the fact that these boats do not steer from the front. Like most motorsports, they steer from the rear. The stern area makes the boat slide around those turns.
We watched a successful negotiation of that turn by the WHM team, the reigning national number ones. Back to Amsoil.
And now they pull those trim systems all the way up, airing the boat out. You want to reduce the friction and get your highest speed you possibly can as they head back out to complete another lap.
Generally good conditions today on this race course. We do have a bit of wind, but not enough to cause any huge concern for these guys. But as you say, Stan, that all is subject to change moment to moment. What else is subject to change? The amount of risk out here. These teams are already laying it on the line financially, personnel-wise, boat-wise, but there are so many hazards out there, hazards that can even put lives in danger.
The Superboat World Championships, presented by Steel, is brought to you by GEICO, MTI Marine Technology Incorporated, Hooters, and by Steel, the number one selling brand of gasoline-powered handheld outdoor power equipment in America.
Superboat International World Championships 2015, Key West, Florida, and we are one lap down in our Superboat class competition here, and already Team Amsoil with a good lead, not insurmountable, but certainly in position, Stan.
A very, very unique team. This team builds their own engines. They are hands-on. They have wrenches in their hands 24 hours a day. They rig the boat. They are very unique. They know this boat top to bottom, stem to stern.
We really are responsible ourselves, and it's a unique situation where we race the boat, build the engines, configure the boat, build a lot of the custom rigging hardware to make the thing go fast. And so it's a unique situation because not many teams actually have control of what they race from beginning to end like that.
I told my son, well, I wanted to go up. I was thinking about going up. And he said, no, stay the way it is. As I said to my son, I said, well, if I come back and our prop selection's too short, I'm going to knee in the
And he puts it on me. He says, you know, if this setup doesn't work, I'm gonna kick you in the nuts. So when you're out there with the wrong props on, it is a long day.
Well, there's always an incentive for getting the boat set up properly, but Bob Teague sort of upping the game a little bit there, wouldn't you say, Stan?
He certainly is. These boats do not have transmissions, so prop selection is critical. Right now, it's obvious they've made the right prop selection here today in these pretty, pretty smooth conditions, 1 or 2 foot chop.
When you look at a lead like that, you think, what could possibly go wrong at this point? Well, pretty much everything can go wrong, Stan, but for now, the AMSOIL team doing pretty well.
They are. I'm checking out those tacks, 6,800 RPMs, 7,000 is the max, 122 miles per hour. They are screaming.
AMSOIL in the lead, in pursuit, second place, WHM, the national champions, trying to gain some ground. Maybe they can get something happening in the turn.
Trying to get out of his right block.
I am. I think
we got caught up on him.
Yeah, we reeled him in on that outside straightaway.
Team WHM trying to reel in, as you heard him say right there, this AMSOIL team gaining a little bit of ground. Broadco holding up third place, and there's fourth place Sailor Jerry.
Sailor Jerry's really making up some time as well as we jump on board their camera looking back towards the stern of the boat. But there is your second place boat right there. WHM trying to gain ground. Steele is in fifth place, and they are adding some speed to their lap times as well.
Easy, we're hot, we're hot.
Okay, go.
There you go, there you go.
Come on, go get Billy.
We gotta get Billy, let's go get him.
Bob Noble, Mark Kowalski doing some self-motivation there. They are going to have to get on their horse if they want to get back into the conversation in this race. What a year for them last year. What a story. A great season, a flawless national campaign, and then heartbreak here at Key West. They're hoping for a better result this time around.
Pre-race jitters, you know, opening day, first race. Yeah, just trying to get going. The whole season is, leads up to this race. This is the culmination of the whole year, and this is for the World Championships.
Last year, and we won 6 out of 7 in regular season races. It's just an unbelievable season. Went the whole entire regular season, never had a breakdown. The boat ran flawless, and we came to Key West.
Here's Steele on the inside, Tommy with a burst of speed coming up and even getting past Broadco.
We had a shot at the World Championship if we won Sunday's race.
How's mine inside?
We're on this side.
We got the lead.
With 6 or 7 laps, we were 22 seconds out in the lead, running good. Thought we had the sure victory, and then the drive falls off.
The Steele is down. Something happened to Steele. I'm being told that they lost their entire drive on the right side.
And we went from winning the race and World Champion to nearly sinking.
Are we sinking? Race control, this is Steele. We need some help here.
So yeah, that's kind of been, since then, that's become the norm. Once you get a taste of it, once you're in that boat and feel that excitement, it's like an addiction.
Get it, go!
And running side by side at 130, 140 miles an hour, it just keeps you coming back. There's nothing like it in the world.
So many highs and so many lows for this Steele team, Stan. The thing is, you just can't keep your eyes off them every time they tee it up.
You never know from 1 second to the next in offshore powerboat racing what's going to happen to you or your boat. I have never seen a complete drive sheared off the back of the transom like they had last year here in Key West.
Well, again, so far in this race, the Steele team has been mired in mid-pack, but look what's happening right here. One of the teams in front, Cleveland Construction, almost looking like they're out of it.
What happened to Cleveland?
They're back behind us. Off to my side. Come on over a little bit more.
We have dropped out right now, or slacked off in Cleveland Construction.
There's an example of how quickly your fortunes can turn around in a race like this. Cleveland Construction right in the thick of things. And now look at them, Stan.
Absolutely. They got hosed down that last lap in one of the turns, and I was concerned about that. These boats do not ingest salt water well.
Race control, number 4. We have an engine problem here on the starboard side. Request to go across right now.
Course Marshal, can you help them?
We dropped off about 2,000-3,000 RPM, and then it started to quit. We wanted to get in the mix and hurt somebody or ourselves.
We
try it. It's only the first day. We got two more days to go.
Well, 3 days total racing. That's a good point. The Cleveland Construction guys will try to get it together for race number two. Again, anything can happen out here, and by that, I mean anything. That still to come. Superboat International World Championships from Key West, Florida. Huge crowds. In fact, this is the second largest event of all events here in Key West during the course of the year. It's certainly the largest sporting event. The people turn out and support this. Today, they've been supporting Team Amsoil, looking very, very masterful, Stan Lane, from the very start of this race.
Oh, wire to wire, they have led, and they obviously chose the right props here. Just as they burn fuel off, the boat lightens up. They're hitting 7,000 RPMs now on their tachometers, both the port and starboard motor. And I'll tell you what, this team is indeed flawless.
Hold it together as the other teams do their very best to try and run them down among the pursuers, well, WHM and also Team Broadco.
I think we got the right wheel. We got the right wheel.
I think so.
We're gonna reel them in.
Get this thing going better, okay?
Yeah.
Start wheeling it to the right. Easy though, just back and forth. Keep this thing free.
Anything you can do to get an ounce more performance out of the boat, including, Stan, the rocking back and forth to reduce adhesion to the water.
Exactly. These catamarans with their twin hulls, you want to dance it back and forth from port to starboard all those hulls. Billy Moff and Jay Miller have been making a lot of time in the turns.
I got to drill a pit to pick up time.
We're going
to
be okay. We're going to be okay. He's still small on his wheel.
Up, 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 up. Up, 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 up. All the way back, all the way back.
Get her straight, good job. Get her straight, get her straight.
Who's behind us?
Broadco.
How far?
Just about 5 seconds.
Go to it. Easy, watch it whip back and forth, back and forth. Go out of this wake. Sweep, yeah, you go. Make me happy, yep. Go in here. Go across it. Perfect. Come on, get straight.
Grant Bruggeman and Chuck Broadus grinding as hard as they can to get further up the standings in this first of three races in Superboat competition. Boy, last year was a fantastic year for them, Stan. Right till the very end, it was a successful campaign here in Key West.
Oh, what a contrast between this year, very, very smooth conditions, and last year, which was off the charts rough and just caused all kinds of havoc.
Yeah, you talk about bumping and grinding through every turn of this race. That was the deal between Broadco and Steele. It was down to those two for the world championship, and what an ending.
Sunday, it was just a survival, you know, to get through that. It was 6 foot waves, 4 foot waves, you know.
Oh, no! Oh! Oh, there's a slope.
They saved it.
20 mile an hour headwinds. The water was a mess, but we came out of there with the wind. You know, we were the last man standing. A lot of boats broke that day.
WHM is having a problem on the outside leg. Your Broadco just got by him. Oh, my.
And then once we knew we had it, it was just such a great feeling.
I mean, it's surreal. The whole experience involved in winning a world championship is just amazing. The most amazing experience that you can experience, obviously, in this sport.
You know, then you just got to, you're only as good as your last race. So you've got to take that momentum with you to the new season. You know, we took it to Cocoa Beach, forced to be reckoned with.
Definitely on top of the world to begin the 2015 season at a place called Cocoa Beach, Florida, where the wind, the waves, the height of those waves can cause some hazardous things there, Stan.
Well, speaking of height, 6 to 8 foot seas, Broadco looking good on the back stretch, but all of a sudden they hit a wave, they launch, they come down sideways, and it's all over.
First rollover, ripped all the hatches off. Next rollover, all the water came in and just blew the boat apart. Chuck had met with Randy Sism of MTI, and they came up with the best solution for the problem. So basically from here up on the boat over is all brand new canopy, new safety glass, and a whole new boat.
Wow, what a start to the season. Not good at all as we watch Broadco back in business. They missed every other event of the regular season. This is the first outing for this Broadco boat since all those months ago, Stan.
Exactly. They've done minimal testing as well. The boat completely rebuilt, and now they've got the safest cockpit canopy in the business, and they're looking good today. They're making up some valuable time as we speak.
Well, there are defending champions. Of course, they got behind it at the start of the season, but trying to hang in there, as is everyone else. Chasing, trying to run down this boat, the Amsoil boat. What a performance as we finish up lap 8, head into the final lap.
They are the cream of the crop, the top of the food chain today. But as you said earlier, we have two more rounds to go, so anything can and probably will happen.
Absolutely. A three-race schedule for these teams that want to hoist that trophy at the end of it all as the world champion. And the last race, of course, points are doubled, so that allows for a lot of volatility. This thing is far from over, no matter what happens here on day number one of racing.
Good turn. Stay right where you are,
right where you are.
Let me get it running. Good job.
There it is, everybody.
We're back there.
Boy, they never give up. Billy Moff and this WHM team trying as much as they can to do something to get closer to this Amsoil team. They do not want to lose on points. They're not going to run them down, but boy, they're not going to be run down either, it looks like.
And close is the word. Amsoil's rearview mirrors are full of WHM. They are gaining ground. Look at that. Not much of a lead. It's going to be a drag race, Tommy, to the finish line.
Absolutely. WHM trying to pour it on all the coals in the final moments of this race, but it is not going to be enough, it looks like.
Amsoil closing in, and they're taking the checkered flag as we speak. What a race. A couple of more laps, it may have been a different ballgame.
No doubt about that. WHM team closing in very hard on Amsoil, but hey, hats off to the team from California, Bob Teague and company. Very much concerned about being set up properly for this race, getting the right prop size to dig them through the turns and still get top speed on the straightaways. And they have done it today and done it to perfection. So they're going to collect top points right there as we see how they lay out through these teams there. Cleveland Construction couldn't finish all the way. They'll still gain some points there. These guys on top, Amsoil today, mighty proud of an accomplishment.
How you like us now?
Great.
He threatened to kick my ass over the setup. See how that turned out.
No, it was just the prop. Setup I chose. I was worried about being too small.
Yeah, we were between props. I was one way, he was the other, and
I went with them because I didn't want any whiners, but the boat was perfect.
And I'm willing to get my ass kicked for a win.
It was perfect.
That was awesome, man. That was a lot of fun. I think one more lap we maybe had him, who knows? But see what happens if it gets a little rougher. He's got a smaller boat, so it gets in and out of the tight turns pretty good, but this thing runs good in the calm as well. But if it bumps up a little, I think we got a real good shot at winning. We'll work on a little more setup stuff tomorrow and see where we go from here Friday. Thank you.
The Superboat teams have one race of three in the book so far. When we come back, we're gonna go over to Superboat Extreme, this class. Well, things can get scratchy over here as well, maybe even before the race starts.
The Superboat World Championships presented by Steel is brought to you by MTI, Marine Technology Incorporated, WHM, Plumbing and Heating Contractors, Steel. To see the full line of Steel outdoor power equipment, go to steelusa.com, and by Lucas Oil.
Superboat International World Championships from Key West, Florida here. A big day, the first day of 3 days of racing for all of these teams already. We have seen the Superboat class itself contest for the first time. Congratulations to the team from California, Team Amsoil, a near flawless performance and picking up top points right there. We move to another class right now. This is Superboat Extreme. We're going to get the monohulls in the action here today. A bit of a complicated start here. Also running in this race, the Superboat V-Class and the Superboat for both stock class. So a crowded close quarters, a lot of elbowing going on here at the start, but the start is fun to watch, Dan.
It certainly is. You got to get the best lane. You want to get the shortest track out to turn number one. So it can be a little bit disconcerting there before you get up on plane, as we see our pace boat displaying orange smoke now. So all the boats will be trying to find their best line. They want to get up, they got to be very, very careful and be aware of where you are on the course.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, a lot of milling around, but we're getting them lined up right now. We are just seconds away from a start, and all these guys, a lot of anxiety, a lot of adrenaline going at this point right here, Bill. But once we get started, they'll maybe spread out just a little bit. Right now, though, again, it's close quarters, and the racing hasn't... Oh, what happened there?
Well, obviously, two objects cannot occupy the same space,
yes.
And a 40-foot boat on your left just ran over a 30-foot boat. I don't know whose fault it was. I'm not casting blame, but there's got to be catastrophic damage to that smaller number two boat floater, and Tommy, their day could be done.
Yeah, the Superboat V-Class boat floater boat right there. We'll have to check in on them. Of course, the camera we saw that from is the Hooters boat. The Hooters Instigator, that's the number one seed, if you will, in this class that we're watching here, Superboat Extreme.
They are reigning and defending national champions as we see the green flag flying, and we are going racing, but without boat floater back there, as Cooper Sander takes an early lead now, that beautiful 42-foot red fountain. But we are back on board Instigator on their bow cam now, Tommy, as we head out to turn number one.
Boy, this has been a rivalry all season long. National number one, Hooters Instigator, and Cooper Standard, the Twisted Metal Motorsports Wing. Those two have been at it nose to nose all season long, and nothing's different now that we arrive at Key West.
They are sister ships, identical with identical power as we jump on board Hooters Instigator. You see the more of a jostling aboard these V-bottoms. They don't get quite the smooth ride the catamarans do. On the inside is Cooper Standard. He has the advantage going into turn number one, and he indeed takes the shortest route through that turn, and he is in the lead.
Right, a lot of racing left to go. We're into the short leg of this three-legged race course right here. Headed into turn number two, and Cooper Standard with the lead right now. We should mention that these guys, unlike the Superboat class we saw earlier, they're not doing nine laps, only six for this group.
It is indeed a sprint race, and we see Hooters Instigator cut through the wash. Not once, but twice as they come again. They're doing anything they can to get the advantage as they head down now past our vantage point, almost side by side, Tommy. Oh, it's a great battle. There's your leader. You see the water being expulsed from the bow area. They are bleeding off ballast to lighten that hull up. As we check out our third place there, that sinister five-step bottom boat, it's called Outer Limits.
Outer Limits in there. Joe Scrow, the driver, the throttle man, is Steve Curtis. This team right here has had a spotty season so far, but looking to score big here in Key West.
Look at the jostling these driver and throttle men are taking. It's kind of like playing football with no pads on out there as we head out to lap number two of six.
Six laps. Oh, wait a minute. Freedom. The Freedom boat not sounding good. That's the first thing you notice right there. Jackie Riper, Joe Ferrer. Looks like they are not going to continue, are they?
Husband and wife duo have to be very disappointed here in round number one to not even finish one lap. But let's get back to the action now, because it is indeed heating up. Hooters Instigator starting to close down the gap a little bit on their sister ship, as Outer Limits is trying to get back up in the fray for the lead as well.
Right now, Outer Limits, bear in mind now, with the Freedom boat out, they can do no worse than third place in points in this four-boat field.
Your leader headed down, looking right down the gun barrel at that bow as it heads towards you at about 120 miles an hour. They are our current leader, Cooper Standard, but just off their port side is Hooters Instigator trying to run them down, Tommy.
Yeah, this great back-and-forth battle going right in front of the crowd here in Key West. Loving it, loving the sound of this old-school Holley Dominator-style carburetor, your natural aspiration for these engines. It really contributes to the entire experience.
Johnny Pop-Pop Stanch, Peter Meyer on board. They're national champions. They would love to be world champions. They were world champions in 2014.
Great stuff so far in this race. We have seen a lot so far, and we're barely halfway through. Much more Superboat Extreme competition coming up. International Superboat World Championship, Key West, Florida, presented by Steel. We are back in Key West, right in the middle, almost a halfway point of our Superboat Extreme race right there. That's the second place boat, the Hooters Instigator boat, who had a collision earlier today with this boat from boatfloater.com. in a different class, the Super V class here. You can see the damage on the side of the boat. And here is the way it went down.
Wow, both boats trying to get up on plane. And what that does, it gives you a lot of bow rise. It's hard to see out there, but that smaller boat definitely took the impact, and it was pretty significant. You see right there the cockpit canopy, the safety canopy definitely cracked, definitely compromised.
Absolutely, and this was all before the race started in the milling period. A lot of boats out there, again, running three classes at the same time. But take a look right here. Look how this visibility is pretty bad right there. You don't see anyone in the path of the Hooters boat right there. You see the little sliver that boat, and you can barely see it. That's from a camera on top of the hull.
Ooh. Well, there are no traffic cops out there to direct traffic, and
no.
That was a terrible mishap. But those things happen. It's just racing.
Absolutely. These guys talk about great visibility, but it's not great at all times, especially, as you say, Stan, before they get up on plane.
And Johnny looks over to his left. Was that a speed bump?
Basically, there's a big hole right in the bow of our boat, right where the boat initially made impact, and then there's cracks all along the inside of the cockpit, which took the integrity out of the canopy, and therefore it's just not safe to race anymore. Been doing it for 7 years, and that's probably the scariest thing that's ever has happened to me. Basically, this is where the boat initially made contact. This is where the bottom of their boat initially drove up on our boat, and then proceeded the whole rest of their boat, just slid over ours. And as you can see, there's a bunch of gouges in the canopy right there. There was a piece of their skeg stuck in the bottom of our boat, and this is basically where the props and the drive slid right over us.
Well, terrible mishap, especially for boatfloater.com. Amazingly, the violence of that strike there, not so much damage done to this boat right here, the Hooters Instigator boat, running really, really well. And take a look at what's happening here.
Running well indeed. Look here, they're making a pass now. They are getting by Cooper Standard. They're side by side right now as they head down our way, Tommy, and they are getting by. They are your leader now in Super Boat Extreme.
What a pass right there, comprehensive and very, very quick after trailing the entirety of this race so far. A dramatic, quick pass right there, and now opening up big time ground.
Hooters either found some speed or Cooper Standard lost some speed. Oh, they did lose speed.
Oh,
they blew a drive. Oh, that's a shame for number 30. Cooper Standard, they have lost the drive. They are well off the pace now. They'll be lucky to finish the race.
Yeah, now just opening up big, big leads over the rest of the field right now. One more look at this, though. You can see how dramatically and how quickly something like this can happen.
Yeah, they were at top speed, and then all of a sudden they lose a drive on your left, and you can see how the dramatic loss of speed takes place, and you know there are some high fives going on aboard Hooters Instigator.
Oh, absolutely. That's their nemesis. These teams back and forth all season long, and now in total control, the Hooters Instigator boat, Peter Meyer, John Stanch, way behind as the Outer Limits boat in a two-boat race is what we're down to now.
Outer Limits has been very, very fast. They've had the acceleration off the turns, Tommy, but they have not had the top end speed. I think they short propped themselves as they come into our last lap. The checkered flags are being raised now as Hooters Instigator heads down to take that checkered flag. In round number one, they are your winner.
Hooters Instigator wins yet another round against this Cooper Standard twisted metal motorsports racing boat right there. What a rivalry. It's been all season long, but this team's going to get the upper hand today and the advantage after 1 day, 3 days of racing here in Key West.
Handshakes all around. They'll take that 250 points and put that in the bank. But don't forget, it was half points in round one, half points in round two, but Tommy, full points for round three.
Yeah, this is far from over right now on Hooters Instigator if they wanted to ice it for good. Would have to win tomorrow as well. That would pretty much do the job for them right now. But work is not done. As we stand right now, let's take a look. We are in the book with our points at Hooters Instigator. 250 possible for the winner, and they got that. Outer Limits would wind up with second place points of 225. Cooper Standard and Freedom did not finish this race right there. They get points anyway, 182.5. So the Hooters Instigator team, not a bad start, but trailing for a good part of the race behind the Cooper Standard Twisted Metal Motorsports Racing team, but able to pull it out due to some misfortune on the part of Cooper Standard at the end. Far from done here, but time to breathe a sigh of relief.
We just ran our first race. We finished first, and we had a little dropped into another boat at the start. And so we have to go back and assess, see if we have any damage and what we'll be able to, you know, take care of and get ready. This is the first race. There's three races. It's basically a drag race out there on the water. It's the fastest and it's the most competitive.
Hooters Instigator getting the better part of the drag race on this day. And be a day they'll not forget soon.
Oh my God, they just hit! Oh my goodness!
For the effort, they get the nod for today's Steel Power Move.
Well, just like steel, these boats do not quit. They just keep on going. And I tell you, I'm just glad nobody was injured.
Yeah, that's our Steel Power Move for today, surviving adversity. And when we come back, well, we're just not going to have any limitations at all and very few rules. This is the Superboat Unlimited class, the biggest and fastest of all, when we return. Welcome back to Key West, Florida, the Superboat World Championships presented by Steel, and this is what a lot of people have been waiting for, the biggest and the baddest, the fastest fleet of the day, Superboat Unlimited.
We've got turbochargers, we've got superchargers. These boats are going to let it all hang out at speeds upwards of 175 miles per hour. It is, Tommy, beyond exciting.
Seven boats in the Superboat Unlimited field, and they are just about ready to go.
Limited class is kind of every racer's dream. No rules, as fast as you want to go, as big as horsepower as you can make.
There are no rules. You can have as much power, you can have anybody's engines, any size boat.
The boats can be as big, as fast. There's no technical limitations at all to the boat. You could have four engines, you could have two engines, you could have 50 foot. It's basically anything goes.
Okay, all racers, next race, prepare to follow the pace boat.
All right, we are moments away from start time, the Superboat Unlimited race. It's gathering, our people are gathered. There's much anticipation for this one. Seven unlimited boats in this field here today. We've got a brand new feature we want to roll out for you. We take a little bit closer look with our MTI in-depth feature right now. Let's pick out three of these MTI boats and look at them.
Yeah, let's do that. MTI dominated this class four out of seven, but let's look at three that we think have a great shot at being world champions. The first is Jeff Harrison, Johnny Tomlinson in CMS 03, 48-foot MTI. It is beyond fast. And here's the gentleman who builds these boats, Randy Sism. He's on board number three CMS alongside Bob Bull, the team owner, 52 feet in length. And number three, CRC Sunlight Supply. This is the former Gasse boat, which was very successful, and they've won numerous titles. Mike DeFries and Todd Beckman aboard CRC.
That's our MTI in-depth report right there. The first boat we saw there, the CMS 03, is national number one, the number one finisher after the regular season as we get close. Very close stand to start time.
Start time indeed. The green flag is being raised, and all the horsepower in the world is being unleashed now in these blue waters as we start lap number one. I'm seeing two CMS boats almost side by side, Tommy, as they head out to turn at number one. Geico coming up. Now that says three on top of the bow, but that is 03, right, Tommy?
That's right. That's the three boat on the left over there pulling even with the Geico boat. You can see the rain showers at this part of the course. It's not throughout the entire course. Good racing between the Geico boat and the three boat early on in this nine-lap race.
And number three had the inside lane. That gives them the advantage, and they're making full use of it now as they are in the lead. Looks like Geico in second. 03 coming through now, making a real nice turn on that big catamaran as they head down now to bluer skies towards turn number two.
It's a three-boat race right now. Geico 3 and 03. MTI boats, boy, Geico boats going to have to do everything they can bring to bear to stay up with these strong, strong contenders, these orange and black boats.
Number three is your leader. They come by us. Lap number one, that is 52 feet of MTI. Geico, a 44-foot victory just behind.
03 boat pulling up in third place and not too far behind, Stan.
Going through the wash of Geico, not once, but maybe twice. And there's the lone monohull in the class, Lucas Oil. We'll jump on board then. Nigel Hook on throttles. Jay Johnson is the driver. This is a very, very narrow boat. You can tell the cockpit. It's like a little guided missile out there.
Absolutely. Lots of technology on board, too. We'll talk about that later on in the week here. But right now, the number three CMS boat in the lead.
Randy Sism, he builds these boats, and he is on board. He knows this boat upside and down as Miss Geico trying to find some speed. That's probably the heaviest hull out there, Miss Geico. They were hoping for rougher water.
Lap number two right now. Place boat is the 03 boat, the CMS boat, in this three-boat race that we got going on right now. The rest of the field kind of falling back just a little bit at this point. What a dominating performance so far from the three boat.
Haven't put a stopwatch on these guys, but I know they're going 175 in these perfect conditions. Just enough chop to free up these heavier hulls, and it's looking good. Their fans are getting a great, great show.
Absolutely perfect weather and water conditions right now. Despite just a little spot of rain, that's not going to slow these guys down at all.
Mike DeVries and Todd Beckman aboard that brand new boat to them. First time they've ever raced it is right here for the World Championship. What a way to get your feet wet. Now, these guys have raced many times before, but not in this hole.
Bob Bull is the owner of that number three boat, also the 03 boat as well. So the team is fighting the team today.
Let's talk about these boats, the power inside. They are twin turbocharged, 1,650 horsepower aside.
But look at the Geico boat right there, almost totally without power. Something big has happened there, Stan.
Tommy, I saw a huge rooster tail. I'm also seeing water dripping in the cockpit. They may have gotten hosed down in one of those turns, but a gigantic rooster tail. They're definitely starting to come off plane. Now, they're allowed to make repairs on the water, and I hope that's the case. They can get this boat back up. They're still moving. They've still got propulsion.
All right, got a little bit of propulsion right there. We don't want to count them out yet. We'll have a full update on the Geico boat situation. We come back in just a few moments.
The Super Boat World Championships presented by Steel is brought to you by GEICO, MTI, Marine Technology Incorporated, Steel. To find a Steel dealer near you, go to steeldealers.com, and by WHM Plumbing and Heating Contractors.
World Championship action from Key West in the Super Boat Unlimited class a few minutes ago. Lap number three of this nine-lap race, we had the two CMS boats fighting with the Geico boat for the top spot. Basically a three-boat race, and then suddenly Geico with no power or little power.
Geico in the hunt until that happened. Massive rooster tail. Their day is done. They're headed back to the cranes to get on the hook. Hate to see that for those guys.
Yeah, one of their better performances of the year right there, but they've got to turn it in, go to the inner harbor, and reassess the situation.
We lost a motor. You know, we were forced to use a motor that had a lot of time on it. Anybody who saw us in the milling area, you could see that one motor was smoking. We knew we were going to be challenged. Our goal was to get up and just, you know, be in the right zip code, set us up for the next couple of days. You know, we ran at 70% power just to stay up there. And ultimately, through the telemetry and everything, they called us and said, guys, you know, just sit tight because it's coming. And you know, we watched it. We felt it in real time as it went away.
Geico's got a faint smoke coming out of port motor again.
Limited class, you're always pushing the limits with horsepower, and you're trying to achieve the most you could possibly get. That speed-wise and power-wise, the downside of it is as you push limits, sometimes you see failures.
Back to the shop for the Geico boat. That is unfortunate. Meanwhile, we're on lap eight. The Superboat Unlimited class right there, and still CMS 3 in the lead. 03 not too far behind, and joining the fray, the CRC offshore racing boat.
Headed into their last lap. Here's the time when you start to hear little mechanical noises. You get scared, you got the butterflies still going. You're hoping and praying just one more lap, and we'll have a checkered flag. Can they do it?
Yeah, you think these guys are going to let it all hang out on every race, but in the back of your mind, Stan, you know you've got two more races after this. If you want to achieve the championship, that's a tightrope to walk right there.
The good news is these unlimited teams have unlimited finances. They got plenty of backup motors, so don't worry about that.
Yeah, don't worry about the Geico team. Very sophisticated and a lot of gear back there at the headquarters.
CRC reeling in at number 03 now for second place, but there is your leader, and they have been almost the entire race, Tommy, number three class of the field.
They just got to avoid any kind of mishap as they just have one more turn and then one long stretch left to go.
Look at this battle here for second place coming through the turn in the inner harbor and now headed back out. Look at the wash now. You want to avoid that at all costs. A lot of talk going on those radios. A lot of nerves out there.
Absolutely. These two member boats of the same team going at it here. Team CRC trying to make it a little bit closer. Going to pick up no worse than third place points here.
This has to make Randy Sism very proud. A proud papa. He's got three boats in contention. They're all MTIs.
The three boat firmly in charge for 99% of this race right here. And they're going to bring it home without incident. The crowd very appreciative of this masterful effort in the unlimited class.
Here they come. Look at the checkered flag waving. Gloriously for number three. Hats off to Bob Bull and Randy Sism. What a job, guys. Well done. Second place coming through 03. So it's back-to-back wins, 3 and 03. So that camp has got to be very, very happy, the camp of CMS. And on third place will be Team CRC Sunlight Supply.
Great success for CMS 3 in this first of three races that comprise the World Championship here in Key West, Florida.
And here are your official results in Superboat Unlimited. Bob Bullen, Randy Sism, great job in number three.
Superboat V class, our winner was the LSB Lily Sport Boats team, boat number 66.
And in production three, it was Second Amendment, Carl Steger and Neil Wobey. Good job, guys.
About production four, Crazy Chicken took that one, D. Early and Anthony Silveira.
And in Superboat stock, the Outboard Boys, Kyler Talbot, Jay Muller, and Talbot Excavating.
Okay, coming up, Superboat Extreme. We saw it. Hooters Instigator, the number one boat, taking the top prize here at Key West.
And in Superboat, it was Paul Whittier, Bob Teague. Great job in Amsoil.
Thank you so much for being with us today in Key West in this first of 3 days of racing. World Championship Day is getting closer and closer. Round number two for all our classes the next time we see you.